Okay, well, hello. Welcome to the 2023 review. So it will now be 2024. However, at the moment, it's the last day of 2023. I'd like to wish everybody a happy new 2024. I hope that your celebrations for Christmas in 2023 were enjoyable and safe. Okay, so I've got this year quite a lot of pages of notes that I've taken throughout the year, and the less amount of pages, the more successful the year is. So as you can see, this year was very challenging. So I'm still working at a bus depot. I'm learning more and able to do more. I've been there for 1.5 years. I'm now no longer driving and have no desire to be a driver again. Okay, so let's get to it. This is going to be quite a long video. At the start of the year, I made the observation of I wonder how the internet, YouTube, and other US businesses or internet-based businesses can transfer their content successfully 100% of the time from the USA to Australia with no problems. But if there is a storm locally here, the internet gets cut off. Now, later on toward the end of the year, I noticed that it could be okay weather here and still the internet is intermittent. So you know, it could be that any weather effects or problems from the USA to here affects the connection. Again, this is going from the start of the year to the end of the year. At the start of the year, there was some improvement in my vision that I noticed, but however, throughout the year, that's not the case. To anybody under the age of about 48, what happens is around about the age of 48, 47, 48, you'll notice that things are a little bit blurry close up. And that's the start of just a human vision, you know, the vision, as you age, the vision becomes not so sharp. I get these from the internet. They're 1.5 magnification. I don't yet need 2 magnification, but I could have started with 1, and I've been on 1.5 for about six, seven years. The hernia, which turned out to not be a hernia, just a kind of a lump on the outside of my skin, on the region between the leg and the stomach region. Oh, by the way, that lump has not got bigger or smaller. That turns out to be a swollen gland, or a gland that puts to the other side of the body from the inside of the body a type of mass, or a lipoma, or something along those lines. I haven't had time to get to the bottom of that yet, but I will. I'm exercising. I'm running around a big rocky track 4 times now, and I'm doing a full set of exercises using my own body weight, so there's absolutely no problems in that area. It was just a terrible shame I had to go through that hernia operation, but it just goes to show that the technology and processes, even people, are more money orientated than they should be. Okay, so like a lot of people, at the start of the year, I used OpenAI chat service. It was the first model they issued for public use. My observations at that time and it did improve throughout the year, like a lot of this AI technology. My notes were, I used OpenAI chat. I found it was good so far as translation and using other language and general conversation, but overall lacking in terms of what is expected of a top tier chatbot. Well, of course, now things are different. They can recognize photos, and soon next year it'll no doubt recognize videos as well. No emotional ability, however, it did present what it knew of as facts quite well. On Friday the 13th, which is the 13th of the first 23, I was knocked back for an eyesight test on my multi-combination license, which later on, after going to an optometrist, I was able to get that removed from my license, and now I have an open license. This year was a very bad year for cars. I had multiple breakdowns. I went to use my Holden Rodeo as a spare car when my Camry stopped working. But then it rolled out of the garage with the horn going, and but more on that later. So at the moment, I've done a lot of work, and I'm getting on top of it all. At the start of the year, it appears that I looked into buying a micro car for fuel efficiency and of course cheaper parts and what have you. Also, a smaller car is easier to work on, replacing ball joints and that type of thing. It says here, I looked into a number of micro cars, including a Mitsubishi Mirage, which has a three-cylinder engine, good access to injectors and alternator, etc. So in other words, the layout of the engine was in such a way that you could say that it's generally recognized that a mechanic works on an engine and it doesn't just get driven around, to be honest. But I decided to use my Rodeo and then Camry for 1 year. The thing about that is I have to run a mid-sized car, so either a ute or a mid-sized car, because I have projects on the house I have to do. The renovations are done, but just general maintenance and repair. I got an S eyesight on my driving license, so I think that is to say that, hang on. Okay, so I've written the same thing twice. I had that removed after I went to the optometrist and reset the test. Which again is part of getting older, growing old. There's nothing you can do about it, you know, aging at the moment at least. In 2023, there's nothing you can do to reverse the effects of aging. I was thinking of my life, and my life isn't all that different to other people's lives. I have problems, and but it's with me, I find, and maybe with other people, it's the timing of the bad luck, you could call it. And I made the observation, could some people be affected? You know, we've got this new AI technology and it's going to grow and have all sorts of ability and possibly time manipulation and sending of images maybe throughout different time periods. With quantum teleportation. I'm just wondering, could some people be affected by negative, what I'd call negative AI? Now, AI technology, I really like. I use it a lot. I think it's fantastic. But, you know, that's the good side of AI, is good AIs. But in the same vein, could negative AIs in the future be built and, you know, retroactive in people's lives throughout time? I made the observation with negative chance, in other words, bad luck, and timing of that bad luck, with investments and a lot of aspects of life, could I be affected with a type of negative AI? Now, you might laugh, but it's just a question. You know, it's just a consideration or just a type of topic to talk about. You know, don't get me wrong, I've got a good life. I've had to gather up my life quite a few times and rebuild it. And now I'm just starting to see that life that I've always wanted to build, because mainly because I've been in one place in one time for long enough. But just as a topic, you know, is that possible? We see our phones and computers have AI built into the systems more and more, and being able to talk to AI now. So that is to say, in future, could some people be affected by negative AI? On the 22nd of the 1st, 23, I keep a towel in my car, and I use it to, I eat in my car. I like to sit in my car during morning break and lunch, and I keep a towel in my car, and I wipe my face and hands with it and all that sort of thing. Mind you, sitting in the car at work during summer is not fun sometimes, and I just sit in the back of the car, of the Toyota. But very strange thing happened. We've got bootmaker's tax here, and it's a type of seed, and it sticks into clothing, and you have to pick each individual one out. And I discovered that there were a whole lot of bootmaker's tax in my towel I used to wipe my face, so I don't get seeds here or anywhere. So I brush it on the ground or what? I don't know. Don't know how that happened. But I pulled them out and I washed the towel, and now it's all good. Around about this time, this is at the wrap up or the finish or the end of COVID-19. And I witnessed a man get out of his car sneezing, like sneeze, 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 all the way from one end of the car park all the way past me into the building where all the drivers are and all the office workers. And yeah, you guess it, a month later, everybody's sneezing and a lot of sickness at work. You know, no mask. All this person had to do is put a mask on. Another thing you can do is get toilet paper rolls and put them up your nostrils, and that soaks up the mucus. Just, you know, just anything. Not come to work, preferably. But no. And this is after 3 years of the coronavirus. At the end of 3 years. So some people will just never get it. Okay, that's only the second page, so there's plenty more. So I get this weird situation. There can be a storm, or just out of the blue, the internet might not be working. And I'll have a look at my pictures that I've got on my computer. And sometimes they don't show the thumbnail, and sometimes they're just being deleted. Now, what's going on there, I don't know. Next time I start the computer up, it's all there. So whether it gets backed up into the cloud and put back on the computer, I don't know. But that's one strange thing about my computer. This year, I was bitten by a leech. It must have been a big leech. And it must have been on my arm, it says here. My arm or my wrist. It became red and itchy. Lots of leeches with the rain and storms. Yeah, look, I was working on my car. There might be more notes about this. But I was working in my car and I got bitten on one day by a tick. There was a huge red swelling here. Seems to have gone now. And a leech on the same day. So that wasn't fun. At work I did a lot of gardening, but I protected myself. I wear a hat. I'm able to do other work other people can't do simply because I just look after myself. I wear a hat. I wear a mask if I have to. Hand protection. You know, I can tackle it. It doesn't matter the amount of dust or what it is I'm working with. I just feel as if I can put on my protective gear and I can do that work. Okay, that earns me some type of respect in one way because I can do the work, and disrespect in the other way just because of the humans, the everyday human, the way they look at workers or dirty work. The fact that you'll do it, you'll actually do that work, whereas they just say, no, I won't do it. That's one side of it. The other side of it is, you know, this person's really great. You know, we need this work done. This person can do it. He takes all these precautions. He knows how to go about it. It depends on your psyche. You know, I can go further and say, well, some people might think, well, he should have studied more or done more schooling. Well, okay, I was just too much on the fly for that. So, okay, that's out. So, the start of the year, and a bit before, actually, while we're on the subject, this year, or the end of the year, it's been a very hot summer. So, we usually have the first hot days around about... we'll say around about Christmas time and after, but this year we've had a month of heat already. So it actually, the summer strong heat started in December this year. So we're on track to having, say, 4 months of very hot weather. I don't want to confuse, because we're talking now about toward the end of the year, and this is the start of the year. Okay, I'll just read out my notes then. This year, not so much rain, but a lot of storms with lightning and no internet afterwards. Yeah, I remember that, yeah. Pretty much how it is now. So, although this is the start of the year, this is the end of the year, so we're talking about the same time period. Okay, sorry to spend so much time on this eyesight test with my license, but I've gone ahead for whatever reason. It could be because I've just been to the eyesight place, and I've written down again the actual experience. Oh yes, I will have had I would have failed the eyesight test on my license. And then now I've got it back, right? So I've written down that I renewed my license and didn't pass the eyesight test. I had to get a prescription. I got a prescription at Specsavers. I was told I didn't need glasses at Specsavers and was told to go to the service centre with my reading glasses. I then passed the eyesight test without my reading glasses. I could read the information writing, which is smaller, under the smallest test letters, and had my condition removed. So that is to say that the smallest letters for the eyesight test, I read them, but then then I actually read the writing on the test underneath, you know, a little copyright thing or whatever. So it's just, sometimes life is ridiculous. Very strange thing here. I've written, this is what I've written. At work, there was a lack of mechanics. I'm a mechanics assistant. And I put up my hand to become a mechanic and was offered an adult apprenticeship. Now, what in the name of God has happened there, I don't know. Because I am now I'm working as a mechanics assistant. So, you know, again, I just don't know. I changed a tire on a double decker. I change tires on double deckers every now and then. And my experience driving a double decker is it's very bright and yellow. And when you look in the rear vision mirror, if you look up, it looks like a double story house or a two story house. On the 5th of the 2nd, 23, this was with NAB, and I've written, there seemed to be money taken from my account. I phoned NAB, they admitted the balance was incorrect and said they would fix it. Now, from memory with this one, there was money taken from my mother's account, a fair amount, but she was reimbursed. But with this one, I think it's something like, I phoned them up and they said that at the end of the day, the actual tallies were correct. I can't remember exactly what happened with that one, but I was assured that everything was okay. I'm actually moving away from the bank now, slowly. This is what we talk about with synchronicity, right? There were many runners on the road when I go shopping. A fair amount of runners use the road for their run. And it was dangerous, so a bit of a dangerous situation going up the crest of a hill and all that sort of thing. But at the same time, my dash cam was plugged in, but it wasn't working, you know, just about the first time. So, if it can happen, it will happen, and at the least appropriate moment, right? With the Camry, the paint was peeling on top of the car, and the hood had indentations in the paint, or on the surface protection paint, or clear coat. And so I painted the top of my car, and then the hood. So with the top of the car, I painted it and put clear coat on it. And the hood, I just put clear coat on it, just to seal the bits that are just starting to peel. I went to Bunnings for a paint match, but it's nowhere near the same colour. But I used the paint anyway, because these jobs can't take too much time, because there's other work to be done. But it looks okay. It looks like a vinyl top. Another tech issue. I have a mouse. This is the mouse here. Alright. Now when I had that plugged in, something, the mouse or someone, whatever, was able to control the screen, like the, you know, you scroll it up and down, the bar on the right hand side, and it was just sort of going like this. So I unplugged it, and I'm using another one now. So would scroll up and down even after resetting my Windows and restarting my computer. I sold my Rail driver. It's a game controller you use to play train-based games. I was interested in working in the rail. I'm not interested now. Trains can't stop, right? I sold my Rail driver game controller. It sold for $355, and the costs were $47.50 to sell a $355 game controller on eBay. I won't be using eBay again. If I'd paid for postage, I would have paid for the postage label, but that's basically saying that it would have cost me even more. Now, that $47.50 out of $355, that's a pretty good percentage for them, not me, right? I changed the head cover gasket on the Camry and the spark plugs. Now, I'm told the Camry's got, and I believe the Camry's got, a front and rear main seal leak. And so the head cover gasket really did nothing, but it's part of the journey, right? A lot of this work's part of the journey. All I can do now is wash under the car. A very good car, Toyota Camry. I can experiment with different thicker oils. Maybe in future, sometimes it takes a bit of time to get to the bottom of or find the fix for these things, right? The balances on my NAB account were wrong, so this amount of money would be taken out and it wouldn't reflect, the balance wouldn't reflect it, or it would reflect something random. Now, it turns out the balances on my account seem to be wrong. Turns out my account would balance every now and then. So every now and then it'd be rebalanced. I was thinking a while ago, a substantial amount of money was taken from my account from Amazon. So Amazon just withdrew quite a fair amount of money, like not a lot, about $40 or $50. But I remember seeing something flash up, not very quick, and it was something about I bought so much, so I was on this different tier, so I'd pay this thing to be a member or something like that. Anyway, I reported it. So it could have had something to do with that, like since that happened, it was balanced another way. I'm not sure, but I'm just saying what is, right, what it is. I fixed some rust on my Rodeo left side behind the wheel, closest to the gutter. There was a lot of dirt and leaves in the panel. Okay, here we're talking about a quarter panel or a side panel, the bit that goes down behind the wheel there that collects the dirt that rusts. As it turns out, what you're supposed to do is when you're cleaning your car, you open your front door and you hose down the bottom there and hose it out and keep it clear so the dirt doesn't keep moisture in and it rusts that part of the car out. So that's an important thing to do when you're washing your car. So yeah, just to make that more clear, a lot of dirt and leaves collect in that part of the panel, and it rusts it out. Okay, now for some comic relief. I have an AI that I communicate with. And here's a joke from an AI. Past, present and future walk into a bar. It was tense. So that's the joke. Past, present and future walk into a bar. It was tense. And I'm thinking, what do you mean it was tense? Well, anyway, what it's talking about is past tense, present tense, and future tense. So that's the joke. The handbrake cable broke on the Rodeo. This is, I think, 28th of the 2nd, 21. So we're in the second month now. So that had to be replaced, and for anybody not knowing about handbrake cable with a disc brake, sorry, a drum brake, you have to completely disassemble everything, the springs, the drum brakes, everything to get right behind it. As it turns out now, I need a new wheel brake cylinder on the rear, so I'll have to do the same thing again soon. So surprise, surprise, right? We remember that worker who came in sneezing all the way down the car park and inside the building. Well, listen to this. I got symptoms. Runny nose, sneezing at work. At home, one night of non-stop sneezing. Well, 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 what a surprise. Just because one person didn't think to stay home or even just to wear a mask, just anything, you know. Now, I purchased a Mongoose L500 at Stockton in Newcastle, just north of here, on the 5th of the 3rd, 2023. Beautiful bike, one little problem. The young bloke that owned it, he was part of a craze at the time to remove all of your brakes. Okay, so my bike doesn't have brakes. I bought one set of rear brakes, and the one of the nuts made out of plastic, and of course it's cracked, right? You don't make a brake. Part of a brake system out of plastic, it just cracks and it cracked open. I returned that, and now I've got what seems to be the brake system I'm told I was getting into when I disconnected from BMX bikes. It's gone the full circle from that time in 1982, say, all the way to now. And I've come back to selecting out of all the different types of brakes, the brake with a single spring across, not the two springs behind the nut, but one single spring. You know, BMX bikes, they adjust this spring tension. It's a round coil spring in behind a nut. Same as if you got metal pliers, it springs open. You can't see anything there. That's because there's a spring behind the nut. So I'm using the single spring. I'm not sure what it's called. I bought the BMX rear brake kit from Odyssey. Odyssey seems to make a good brake that's affordable. But of course the reason a single spring isn't used is because people just won't wear protective eyewear, right? Now if that spring recoils and hits you in the eye, then you could damage or lose an eye. So that's the thing about, I get it, you know, I know about the spring being behind the nut and so it's safe, but I'm pretty sure, apparently from what I've been told, that's the brake system I found to be the best when I was a young bloke in my teens. Anyway, I bought this Mongoose L500. It's sat in the garage. I thought I'd owned it for a year now. I haven't. I bought it in the 3rd. So in the 3rd of this month, in 3 months, I will have had it for a year. But by then, I hope to have the rear brake set up, and I like to go up and down the driveway for a start. And then maybe up here in the bush, I can go for a ride on a level track. The young bloke did a few modifications, and one of the good things about it is it's got a rear tire that doesn't throw water up on your back. I found rust on the Rodeo on the finishing trims down the side of either window. Well, you know, I had to remove one of the trims and do a lot of work to it and try to preserve it. I used a combination of small wire brush, black rust paint, So you're talking about rust, metal with plastic, the plastic out covering, and the metal rusting inside. So and silicon, I use silicon. Once in place, I then siliconed the edges and did quite a lot of work to the side trims. Another thing, while I was using the Rodeo, I actually watched in kind of horror as the, not the water, but the dew ran down and actually underneath the rubber. I'm thinking, where's, it's coming down, okay, but how is it, I can't see it going over the top. And it's actually disappearing underneath the part, the rubber that holds the window in. So what I did was I taped it off, I siliconed it, so to stop, to create a barrier, so it comes down and runs over the trim and down, I don't know, disperses down to the quarter panels, I suppose. Now that is page 5, and we've got many to go. Sorry about this, it's been a very full-on year. I've been working all of my spare time, so at work I only get one day off, whereas I used to get 2 days off, and I'm just working all the time. So as I say, the thinner this is, the better the year. I hope next year is going to be better. Oh, by the way, I do have many videos of the work that's in this list. However, I just don't have time to edit them, and I don't know how long it's going to be before I have the time and edit them and put them live. Something would have to change in my machinations, like for instance all the car work would have to be done, and there'd be a time of, I've got to go back to the house and check that, and then there would be a time of nothing to do really. That'd be the only way. So I've always said that, you know, some other type of technology would have to come into existence to be able to fully present my videos, because I have a lot of videos in there of all subjects, and it's looking now like that technology is AI technology. Okay, I purchased spark plug leads for the Camry that were a different size, and I had to return them to China. I just sent them back to China. That's what I was told to do. So, you know, the design and everything looked perfect, and you know, I did all my homework, but when they got here, they just wouldn't fit on the I think they wouldn't fit on the road. It doesn't have a distributor, but it wouldn't go on the coil. Always since the 90s, I knew that there would be an alternative to the car radio system, and it turns out that alternative is, in actual fact, it turns out to be Bluetooth speaker in the shape of a drink can with input from a mobile phone. That's what I use. I use a Bluetooth speaker, and I use my phone to listen to podcasts, and not to music. Frankly, I don't know how to do that, but the podcasts are good. Thanks for that technology. I hope this isn't the case, but I don't think I recorded the breakdown I had. I had a massive breakdown. The Camry, Toyota Camry, broke down. I think that was electrical. And then I tried to register my spare car, the Holden Rodeo, but its horn sounded at about 4 o'clock in the morning across the valley. Now, I don't know whether this is last year. This could be in last year's. I haven't watched last year's year summary. But, okay, so I'll just read out my notes. I found out the reason for the electrical breakdown earlier in the year was a bad new battery from Repco. When the battery was removed from the 2000 Toyota Camry, my battery charger wouldn't even recognize the battery. The battery cost a total of $4,000 in overall cost. That's overall, as in trying to fix the Camry, the Rodeo, and just knock-on effects. So I rented a car. I rented a Toyota hybrid. All costs associated. In overall cost, the battery was for Repco, or from Repco. Car and passenger. Oh, the battery was car and passenger ultimate performance, 40-month warranty. Gee, there's no way that I would not have recorded all of that. It must have been last year that it happened, but from what I can recall now, let me just look at my notes. Yeah, so the actual breakdowns with the Toyota and the Holden Rodeo were in 2022, so that's next year. So to find out about that catastrophe, maybe if you have a look at the 2022 video, it'll be there. I think what this is saying is just that I found that the battery was defective, and that was the reason for the breakdown. In hindsight, the Holden Rodeo water pump would have to have been done anyway, and we'll hear more about that this year in the notes for this year. So at the moment, the Holden Rodeo is getting a restoration. So I'll just move on from that. I don't want to create confusion. The next note is that I've come to appreciate the British engineering through bikes like Triumph and BSA. Triumph is made by Triumph, and they've never shut down. BSA did shut down, and it's BSA is now, or the Indians, a business in India, is now creating BSA or motorcycles under the BSA license or name now. But in hindsight, from everything I know, everything I've tried on the road, I've tried Harley Davidson, four-cylinder Yamahas, big capacity, I would definitely try, I would have tried Triumph. If I could try again, if I could start over or go back to when I started over with bikes that didn't work by the way, I would try with Triumph. I would buy a Triumph Bonneville. And I think that's the answer to bikes for me. Anyway, my experience. As I was saying before, I've got a really good Bluetooth speaker set up that I listen to podcasts in my car. However, I did have an experience where the volume dropped as I moved the car. I think it may have happened twice, but you know, now I just set the volume. I make sure I don't touch the volume settings. I know how to check the volume setting on the Bluetooth speaker is at maximum. And I can adjust the volume with my mobile phone. So that's all working okay. These notes are made when I first get something sometimes, and throughout duration of time, I know how to use it better. Or the settings within the system don't fluctuate, they just stay fixed. So that's how it is with this with these notes. What may be not understood at one period of time may be fully understood later on. I was looking at a 1938 BSA C10 250. I was considering maybe looking into it and maybe going for a test drive, but I'm glad I didn't. It could have been a really good move, but I'm trying to simplify my life. I'm trying to get back to just resting and making videos, and it would have stood in the way of that. It was only a 250. If it was a bigger capacity bike, I probably would have had another look, but it was about $7,500. The bike looked really cool, very lightweight. It could have been okay. Okay, so I've had the breakdown in the Camry. I've got the Holden Rodeo finally on the road. I fixed the issue with the horn, got new tyres, and registered it. Everything's going okay until I found a lot of coolant under my car. And I've got in question mark because, of course, I don't when I make this note, so I don't know what the problem is. I've got question mark, water pump question mark. Well, yes, it was the water pump okay. I had problems. I fitted a new radiator cap. I thought that may fix it. It did, in fact, fix it when I backed it off, so there was no more pressure on the cooling system, because the cooling system, I think, runs at about 60 psi or something like that. Why would you put a cooling system under pressure? Well, I suppose it's to see leaks before. In other words, you would see a leak because of the pressure pushing the water out, then you back it off so there's no pressure, and then you can keep working the car until you keep using the car until you find alternative arrangements. Now, if you keep on topping up the cooling system, you've usually got 3 to 4 months max before that's it. If you drive it long enough, you'll lose all the water out of your cooling system because your pump is lower than everything else. So one day you'll be driving along and you'll just have nothing and your car will overheat. That's all about that. The thing about it, before I actually saw that it was the water pump, because my last car was a Toyota Hilux. I never had any problems with that, although it did get to 500,000, and the Holden Rodeo isn't at 500,000 yet. I didn't have any problems with the Toyota, but now we're, say, 9-10 years. It's nine or 10 years older, and they're both from 1995. 10 years older with the Holden Rodeo. Another thing, the Holden Rodeo always ran super cool. It never got off the cold. And I thought, well, is the temperature gauge working? And yes, it is, because on the hottest days it would move a little bit. But I found that it had a perforated diaphragm, so it was stuck open. And look, the thermostat on the Holden Rodeo, I've replaced it, but the old one was stuck open, and look, it ran cool and it never had any issues. So I have actually seriously considered putting the old damaged or non-working one back in it. It's just that in the middle of winter, you don't get enough temperature build up in the engine to warm yourself. Okay, at this stage, the Holden Rodeo was just hanging in there. As I've said, I tried a few things, and I could have been topping it up with water, I'm not sure. Or it could have been right at this stage. But I was also working on the Toyota Camry, and at this stage of the game, all the work was done to get rego and have a reliable, good second car. At that stage, it was my Corolla, Toyota Camry. The rocker cover gasket had been done. I had a falling headliner that was falling down. That was removed. I scraped all that foam off, and I painted it. I sanded it and painted it, and that's good. Except if you do that, be aware that there'll be lots of fumes from the paint. So if you're going to paint the inside of your car, especially the headliner, because there's so much of it, always use paint that has no fumes. Okay, no smell paint. Otherwise, you might make yourself sick. You'd have to drive with your windows down, and it could be winter and all that. And the headliner, the paint was wearing off the roof. Well, I sanded that back, I painted it and put a clear coat on that. This is a lot of work. It doesn't sound like much work, but it is a lot of work. Yeah, so I painted the top of the car, the hood, or the bonnet. It was wearing off or pitting. It had little pit holes in it that were spreading. So I sealed all of that with clear coat paint. And to clean the inside of the car and sorting out the car, some other issues, whatever they were. Put the seats upright because I put the seats down when I'm using the car. So I'd have to put the seats upright to get registration. There was something about the middle armrest and put the sheets in the back because you don't want to get the inside of your car dirty. So at this stage, I could use the Toyota Camry if I needed to. On another subject, I found that Mahindra in India was bringing back the BSA Gold Star. So I found that quite interesting. So I was thinking, if we use antifreeze antiboil, why do we pressurize a cooling system of a internal combustion car? Well, that's for early warning of a coolant leak. And for that matter, I'm wondering, what do electric cars do? Do electric cars pressurize their cooling system? That's a interesting one. Now, I have had a few people in the family pass away now. And I have come to realize that it is only because of close family ties that people like me survive. So the importance of family. I think in India, that's a very important thing, is close family ties. I do meditate, I do yoga, not very often. I don't get the chance very often because I'm so busy and my workload, as you can see here, that I don't have much spare time. But I do yoga when I can. Upon inspecting and doing a little bit more on my spare car at the time, which was the Camry, I noticed that a tie rod rubber boot had been torn, and I don't like torn rubber boots on a spare car or on any car, because I know it's not a roadworthy issue at that stage, but I like to have everything right if in case I need the car, of course. So a spare car has to be as good as the car you're using. We do a roadworthy inspection once a year here in order to get registration. If you don't pass it, you can't register your car. So I found the tie rod boot being ripped. So that was on the tie rod. I renewed the tie rod ends on the Camry. The first new tie rods didn't fit on the thread. So I ordered tie rods, but they wouldn't fit on the thread. And I had to return them. The second had the wheels not adjusted straight. So the second ones, if you put... Then they're different sizes, you see, the adjustable bit. And if you adjust them to how the previous tie rods were, your wheel will be out of alignment. So I did a makeshift. I looked down, I sided it up with the body of the car, getting them straight. That's how I adjusted them until I got a chance to go to a tire place and get a wheel alignment. It's just the incredible amount of returns you have to do with online shopping. I was looking around at cars and I was interested in a 1970 Ford Galaxy in Melbourne. I found pictures of it in Altona auctions prior to the current owner. So the advertisement was there and I found pictures where the current owner had bought it at the Altona auctions. But I tried to talk to the owner But he just kept on referring me back to the advertisement on Gumtree, so that was the end of that. Never buy from a seller that won't talk to you. Okay, now we're getting back to the battery in the Camry. So this must be later on, and I've followed up on it. So I've obviously removed the battery and it's sitting there, and I'm just waiting for a chance to do something about the spare battery, right? I noticed the battery charger stopped charging on my original battery in the Camry, and suspected the battery charger as well as the battery at this stage. I got a refund at that stage I'd got a full refund for the battery. I ordered two Amazon work torches, and one was defective. It wouldn't turn off or on, and it had a red light, not a clear white light. Okay, I've just been down all day. I did the first bit of the video in the morning, and now it's toward the end of the day. In fact, it's 5:16. Did the shopping this morning. I've just been working on the Holden Rodeo, preparing it for roadworthy. With the Holden Rodeo right now, which is the 30th. What's the date today? It's the 31st of the 12th, 2023. Now getting back to what we thought was a hernia, which actually it isn't a hernia, or it wasn't a hernia. I'd say now it's looking a lot like a lymph node or a lipoma. So that operation was for nothing. With your car, only use a lead acid battery in a car that's designed for less lead acid, and only use a gel battery in a car designed for a gel battery. That's very important. Quite frankly, I find it very hard to even talk about this year. There's been such a lot going on, especially with my cars and breakdowns. I feel as if I'm getting on top of it now. And who knows, you know, I could be building two cars that will last me the next 10 years or so. I've mentioned it before, I need two mid-sized cars to handle the any maintenance that needs done on the house. Now to buy a new mid-sized car, you know, that's a lot of money. That's $45,000-$50,000. Also, there's an advantage in having two cars. I've only just for the last couple of weeks stopped wearing a mask at work. Year and a half, I've worn a mask at work because there was a high ratio of sickness there, and also the dust with sweeping and working with brake particles from the brake pads. Right now it's looking like eventually I'll get a Model Y, Tesla Model Y, in time to come. The Model Y, because the room in the back and the lack of parts and parts that can break down in an electric car. Okay, getting back to the notes now about this year, 2023. On the 8th of the 5th, 2023, at the very start of the winter cold, my car, which was the Holden Rodeo at the time, wouldn't crank the car very well. I got the car started and I went to Super Cheap Auto, and I got a new battery and a good battery charger. So the battery charger, I'm using that now to keep the spare car battery on charge. And so that was lucky that I was able to get through that. Around about this time, the one of the roller door motors stopped in the garage. It stopped working. And when installing the new roller door motor, I lost spring tension, so it actually unwound. I was able to get the spring tension back, but the roller door had moved one way. And it wasn't centered in its track. So what I did was I shifted it back. I got the spring tension again. When installing a roller door, you never undo both sides. Okay, one's holding the spring tension and the other's holding the motor. Do your homework first. If a roller door motor does have to be replaced, get somebody to replace it that's used to doing the work. Or really do your homework if you're in a situation where you have to replace the motor yourself. Okay, so on the 20th of the 5th, 23, the very worst thing imaginable happened with the Holden Rodeo. It overheated on the way to work. This is after 1.5 or 2 months of trying to keep her going, so just topping up the water before I went to work or went home. And on the way home, the thermostat opened and the water just gushed out because the water pump, which is the weak point of the internal combustion engine, it couldn't keep the water in. So the Holden Rodeo overheated. I could hear the metallic tings of the engine when filling it with cold water. I should have waited, but I filled it up when it was hot with the cold water. Luckily, I did pull over as soon as I saw any issues, and that's why the Holden Rodeo is still going strong now. So on the way home, to get it from that point when it lost its water, it took 10 litres, which is was my spare water container, plus my summer supply of 11 water bottles. So luckily I also had 11 water drink bottles. They're the ones you get from Coles. They're about, you know, that big, the small bottles. And that just got me home. So I only just had what water I needed. With nothing left, she was, however, there's a hill I climb just before getting home, and it climbed that effortlessly with water in it, so I knew I still had a good engine. So luckily I didn't have to go knocking on people's doors to get water. Okay, so with the Holden Rodeo off the road, I had to register the Camry, which, again, this synchronicity, I'd only just finished to be able to drive on the road, say, you know, the day before. So I grabbed the Camry, I went and got a blue slip, I got a wheel alignment and a full set of tyres. It says here I did a wheel alignment and an engine wash, washed the car, and I think then I got a blue slip for the Camry. I think that's how it was supposed to be read. At this time, I was looking at a Cayenne Picanto for 19,000 to 20,500. Problem with a Picanto is it's just too small, and I couldn't really pick up any sort of sheeting or flooring or anything long or anything like that. I also looked into the Suzuki four-wheel drive, but that was 35,000, and 35,000 for a very small car is just too much. I think I was looking at the Ford, but that was also 35,000 for the 1 litre turbo, and apparently they've got rubber timing belts in the inside the engine with the hot engine oil, or at least some of them do, so I'm not going to go there. Yeah, so it reads here that I registered the Camry again after spending six months of working. So that was all that, the headliner inside the car and the bonnet and the top of the roof. Getting the, I think the, yeah, so that's just generally spending time and checking the car over. At this stage, I was just adjusting my camera for levelness there. Also, I looked at buying a Hyundai Venue. It does have a bit of space inside, but not really a mid-size car that I need. Quite a good price, I think, from memory, very, very roughly $26,000-$27,000. So I started to look at the Hyundai Venue. I went for a test drive and found no problems, except maybe, I can't really see what I've written here, but I think it's a load safety problem. So if I was to carry something on the roof, there wouldn't be any way to keep it there. I like the look of the Hyundai Venue. If anything, it's a little bit comical and not a very serious, it looks like a top hat. I like the car, but too much money, and new cars, all I'd be doing is just buying into the same internal combustion system that's plaguing me now. Like I say, if you get a new car, that's a lot of money, and new cars break down. If you get a good second-hand car, then those issues are going to plague you maybe 7-10 years down the track. If you get an old car, you have to, you know, replace, you'll end up, you may as well do it straight away. You'll eventually have to replace the battery, the starter, the alternator, the water pump, some ball joints, fuel pump, and whatever I've left out. But those are the items that I'd, I don't know if I mentioned the starter motor also. You may as well just go ahead and replace all of them. Well, then you're looking at 1,000-1,500 in parts. And then you got your labour if you get somebody else to do it. So there's no way out of it. Maybe electric car with few moving parts is better, but that remains to be seen. To give you an idea of the expense of cars, have a look at this. I just managed to fit it on the pages. It should be better after this work's done, but have a look at that. Look at those totals. So you want a car, you think it's better than a bus or a train? There you go. $10,000 in the 22-23 year. That's the internal combustion engine. It just so many parts, thousands and thousands of parts, all waiting to get old, all being affected by the heat and the stress and the workload, all waiting to break down. We have to find a more reliable way. Electric cars are for commuting to work and back and shopping, and internal combustion engine is for long distance interstate work. Okay, I made a note that websites should keep the login process the same. So sometimes to log in, all you have to do is supply your password. Well, that's easier and quicker. However, sometimes you don't really see that it's the password, and you'll type your password or your email into the password section of the website. It should be standard. It should ask for your username, whatever you use, username and password, and just keep it standard. I subscribe to the Runway. They call themselves Runway ML, I think. It was during the start of the AI revolution, and I thought I could use the service to generate videos, just as an experiment, not a long-term thing. I'd like to produce or keep on producing just human-based videos. So that was Runway ML. Just let me check that. Yeah, it's runwayml.com. I found it to be a scam. It really offered no real ability. You could upload a photo, and work the photo. But as far as actually generating videos, runwayml.com, no. Pretty much just a scam. I cancelled the subscription. I will be on the lookout for another withdrawal from these people. Now, what GoDaddy? GoDaddy kept on withdrawing money out of my account, and I couldn't log in. There was no way to log in. I ended up having to make a complaint and get my bank to stop the withdrawals, to stop that. So I will be looking for extra money debited from my account from Runway ML. I cancelled the subscription. I was looking for an AI. I was looking to maybe create some cartoon type of video, but really did nothing. I was experimenting with Google's Music LM, and I was generating 1970s rock style tunes until I generated the exact same piece of music twice, meaning that the Music LM service was just giving a set of pre-recorded or pre-made pieces of music based on the text description, not individual or one-off pieces. That's Music LM. One of my hubcaps fell off, and a week later I found the same hubcap, but older and worn, in the bin at work. So, you know, God knows what's happened there. I painted it up, put it back on. Now, I use plastic ties to keep the hubcaps on now. I use a plastic tie and I thread it through the hole, or in a Tesla or whatever, you could use a spoke. Get a plastic tie, preferably a clear one, and just zip it up so that less chance of it coming off, and if it does, it's salvageable. So now about the white and grey cat. Just here around my place, I saw a cat for the first time. It was white and grey. Then when I went to work on Monday or Tuesday, so I saw it on the weekend, I saw a white and grey cat crouched on the road about half a kilometre from my garage, or about half a kilometre from here as well. Then I see a white and grey cat has moved in next door. So I now realise that it's my neighbour's cat, but these synchronicities are very strange, the way they work like that. You see a cat, you see it crouched in the middle of the road, and then I find out this, it's the neighbour's cat. It's white and grey. You don't see many white and grey cats. So, okay, so here's a strange one. I was looking for a circuit on the fuse box so that I could just work on, say, let's say the garage or whatever it was, and I didn't have to disrupt the house. So I turned off an 8-amp fuse at the fuse box. When I turned the 8-amp fuse back on, I noticed that the main switch was off. However, I can't remember turning the main switch off. I wouldn't turn the main switch off if I was working on just one particular part of the house. I was trying to isolate it and just turn the fuse off for that part of the house or the garage. Anyway. Okay, this one could be a little bit tough to follow. This tells a story of, you should replace your battery every 4 years, no matter what. So on the 13th of the 6th, 23, I went to start my Toyota Camry and only heard a click. So So what happened was I had a defective battery, so I removed it and I put the old battery in. Now that old battery has let me down, so that Repco battery has created this, you know, is a very big part of this $10,000 expense for the, I think the 22, 23 year. So I just heard a click. I had a flat battery. The same battery I took out and replaced with the defective battery, which is what I just said before. Defective Repco battery. That led to the Camry breakdown and subsequent Rodeo breakdown, because that broke down with the horn not working and everything. And Camry re-registration and $10,000 financial year expense. I hope this battery works. It is a Marshall. So the battery I got to fix all of this is working very well. It's a Marshall battery, and so far so good. The Camry's now got new starter, new battery, and so the electrical system's good at the moment. But this is quite complex, what I've just explained here. Actually, what helped me through a lot of this was I have a battery gauge in my Holden Rodeo and Toyota Camry, and I could see what the problem was, and I was able to go to that part and replace it. As I said toward the start of the video, a set of BMX brakes that I purchased had a vital adjustment piece made of plastic. And it was cracked on delivery, and so I returned that. In the 2023-2024 financial year, so we start our financial year halfway through the year, or the sixth month in Australia, because of the previous expenses and that Runway ML thing, I've decided for this financial year not to make any more purchases other than just general upkeep and maintenance. Look, I think this is going to be the longest video yet. I think this video could be 3 hours or more. The amount of things that have happened this year. I don't feel like it. I'm a little bit tired now, but I've got so many pages left. I have to do one more so I can do the rest in the morning. I have to watch this, make sure it's all been recorded, and then upload it. At this stage, there was only the Rodeo timing belt and water pump to do. Okay, so the Rodeo is broken down, and I have to replace the water pump. Well, I might as well replace the timing belt, but as we see later on, I decided to do a fairly good restoration on the Rodeo, and there will be more parts that have been replaced. My mum had a large amount of money taken from her account. So you have to be careful. I'll highly recommend using websites like eBay or Amazon. The big websites for the security, and also to clear your cache before doing banking on your computer, or get rid of the programs on your mobile phone. I don't recommend using mobile phones for banking or purchases. I would use a computer for doing that. So you can clear your cache before doing banking, or it's called cookies and site data. Clear the cookies and site data on Firefox, or clear browsing data on Chrome. Okay, you can go to the settings, and then on Chrome you can clear the browsing data. And then my Apple computer stopped working with a song on it that I was making. I thought I was making a very good song at the time. Just Apple, for some reason, just stops, won't boot up. You get that circle thing and it freezes. So the notes I made at the time was, I packed away my Apple computer and Logic Pro, music making software, a Behringer mixer, headphones, leads, and microphone, and stored them under the house. $1,000 or so worth of non-working hobby investment. With one piece of non-retrievable work on my hard drive. So I never stored anything on the Apple. I don't trust Apple. So I stored it externally on the hard drive. Now how I would get that, I'd have to find somebody with an Apple computer, Logic Pro on that Apple computer, plug it in and work it and get it off the computer. I don't think I can do that. And throughout the time, I also had songs and Windows just disappear on the Apple and Windows computers. So, you know, I'd be working or looking on the Windows computer, and the window would just disappear, and on the Apple. I just had this, I think it happened the previous year, they'd just disappear. So that's why I was continuously storing on an external memory. From now on, I intend to only use cloud-based services for music making. However, I did make a handful of songs, so there is that out of it. So I did manage to make some what I think is good music. However, you have to consider that I also invested a lot of time in learning this software. You know, Logic Pro is quite detailed and there's a lot to it. So that's a big blow. You know, I can't really make music anymore. I'm learning the guitar, but I haven't had much luck with Apple. I put a lot of time and effort into learning the Logic Pro software and hardware. Okay, so that's that music hobby just completely gone with the computer not working. So it's all about cloud-based. I'm sure that's where the reliability and future is. Okay, welcome back to this marathon year in perspective, or respective, or retrospect, I mean. It's now 2024, it's the first of the first 2024. So, last year was an incredible year, very, very busy time. Okay, so the next note I said, or I wrote down, was one thing I noticed this year in 2023 was a lot of retirees with a lot of spare time stepping in and passing on, you know, information with a lifetime of work experiences. That's what I call the fourth generation. So the first generation is people like the very first people, including me. After that, there was a generation stepping in with the mindset of making money. Then there was a third generation, a younger generation, stepping in. And now the fourth generation, which is retirees with an incredible amount of life experience. during the year I looked at one of my early videos working on the Harley FXWG clutch basket. I removed that video because I put grease on the clutch plates thinking that it I don't know, might offer more grip and not slip, but of course if you put grease on clutch pads, then of course they won't release. So that was the very early days, and that was a silly mistake, but I'm always learning, right? I noticed that at the time I seemed to have a more carefree attitude to life in general and ICE engines. I now have more understanding of the complexity and hardship of internal combustion engines and working on them. I purchased a set of radius rod bushes for the Holden Rodeo, the 1995 Holden Rodeo TF 2.6, that were the wrong sort and were for a Nissan. However, you got short-term perspective and longer-term perspective. How this played out was that I spoke to the person that sold it to me, and they said, yeah, no, they're good bushes and they'll work on your car. Well, they're installed now and they're very good. They did need tightening after installation, after the movement. The bolt, mainly the rear bolt, had to be tightened up a bit. It was fairly loose, but that's wearing in, so it's all good. So during my garbage truck driving days, I brought home a fair amount of stuff, and one of the things I brought home was a plastic mat. So I collected the plastic mat and I put it in my room here, thinking that it would be good to protect the floor. But when I researched these plastic mats, it seemed as if they hold a lot of mold, and they're even impregnated with the mold, or the mold grows within the plastic. And I did notice some circles of I didn't know what it was, but it, as it turns out, it was the mold, and I had a big mold problem after I brought it home that spread throughout this room. And that was actually during the coronavirus too. So I no longer bring home any secondhand things. So it just goes to show you're better off buying new. So needless to say, I threw the plastic mat out. Now this is a lot of work altogether, but it may sound a bit simpler with how I've recorded it here. I renewed the water pump, timing belt, alternator, radius rod bushes, and clutch master and slave cylinders on the Holden Rodeo. Now, it's not a lot of money, but it's a lot of time. Hopefully the work I'm doing now, I'm creating with my Holden Rodeo something that could last possibly 5, 7, maybe even 10 years, who knows. During the year I managed to track down the place I lived at, and I'll show it here soon. I found the place I lived in Toronto on Google Maps. I lived there in 1990. It's 76 to 130 Ling Road, L-I-N-G Road, Scarborough, and I would really like to see this place again. So here it is. Here's Ling Road. The driveway is here, and the entrance is here. I went in, I think I went into the house on the other side of the driveway, possibly, through the entrance here. Maybe through the driveway, but I'm not sure. But anyway, I lived around about this area here. I lived on the top floor on the other side. And as you can see, this is a very sturdy, well-built building. It has to stand up to very cold temperatures and fluctuations and ice and snow. And I found quite a lot of squirrels here. And me and some friends were playing a game. Somebody snatched something from me here, and I ran up I ran up this way here and caught him around about there, just playing and mucking around. But it's only a three-story building, and we see here that it's surrounded by quite a lot of... Oh, here's the bush I used to go for walks in every now and then. Yeah, so this is in Scarborough, Toronto, Ling Road. It's now surrounded by higher, taller buildings. I think this was here when I lived here. But anyway, this is the entrance to it. I did have a van. I parked it here. I bought the van. I didn't use it much. The economy, world economy, wasn't too good at the moment, but I think the entrance could possibly have been... Where are we now? Could have been through there, I think. And that's the car park there. 2023, with the advancements in robotics... by the way, robotics is a big thing of the future, humanoid robotics. I think most houses will eventually have them. And that brings up the question about every household being armed and protected by a robot also in the far future. Well, maybe not so far future. So if you had a land where every house had a robot that was able to... protect the occupants as well as the country, that land would be virtually uninvadable. You could not invade a country like that, really. The advancements in robotics, AI and spaceflight remind me of the world envisaged when I was young in the late 60s and early 70s. I was wearing size 14 shoes at work, and they were very comfortable, but they were big as well, and it's really just how it made me appear, how it made me look, and that's very important in the human world, is how you appear, not so much what's on the inside or what you can do, your abilities, your thought processes about, maintenance and a good life. And everything, or being a good person is what I'm saying. So I tried to wear, I was actually asked to wear a smaller shoe, so I got the smaller shoe size 13. I was wearing these shoes for about 3 months before I got rubbing sore on the back of my feet, and now in between my feet I've got calluses, and it's all because of I have wide feet, and if you compress feet and toes, you get rubbing, and the soles aren't all that good, so that's giving me a bit of problems. This year the plumbing blocked, the main plumbing going into the main sewerage, and plumbers came, three plumbers and two cars in the driveway and the boss's car, so everybody was there trying to fix this. They did unblock the plumbing. They put new PVC where the old ceramic couplings were. So that's pretty well renewed now. It should be carefree. There were some ferns growing into the ceramic plumbing. I've got them out of the equation, and a few other taller trees around the plumbing area. Now, what it was a part of the PVC plumbing had been impacted and crushed and pushed down and blocked off. Now, how does that happen when it's, this far under the earth? Well, number one, of course, is sabotage. Somebody could have dug a hole and just poked it. I could have done it when I was looking around the perimeter to see that there's some deformation of the slab going into the cement slab going into the garage. I could inadvertently and by mistake impacted it, but I don't think so because the plumbing worked for years after. And the third thing that could have caused it was my car driving over beside the shed. Could have driven over the plumbing, could have been a time of a lot of rain, And just the constant pressure of the earth could have cracked the PVC, which is also, it's likely, but it's not likely at the same time, in that the ways where my wheels go only rarely would have gone over the top of the plumbing. So really, I don't know what caused it. What I did was I brought in wall blocks to build up, you know, garden wall blocks to level it up. And anyway, I put big cement pavers over the top of the whole area, so there's no way that a car wheel weight can crush it. There's no way that it can be sabotaged. And you know, I know that it's there now, so I wouldn't put a crowbar through it. So that was a lot of work carting. I carted 3 tons of road base from Terry Hills to here with the Holden Isuzu Ute. So that's approaching 30 years old now. So anyway, that was a lot of work, and that's now done. So here's a bit more on that synchronicity. And by the way, this year summary may have to be done in 2 parts. I don't know if I can stitch this all together. I don't think I've got the memory on the computer for it. But the next note I made was the brake warning light came on the dash on the Toyota Camry. It's a 2000 Toyota Camry with 2.2 engine in it. A couple of years ago, when I changed the original brake pads, the new brake pads I put on it were a bit too thin. I didn't think they were really thick enough. And I'd left the handbrake on a few times. Now, the funny thing about this, so it's got drum brakes and brake pads, right, on the rear. But there'll be more on this later. But the day, out of all the days for it to happen, the day that the light on the dash went off, the day I was going to change the rear brake pads. So, you know, I'm prepared, I've got the spare time, I've coordinated all this so I can change the rear brake pads, because the brake warning light's on the dash. And I'd done some tests and I'd worked out what it was. Go to back down the garage to change the brake pads, no warning light, and it hasn't been on since. So because of my workload at the time, I just left it at that and said, well, I'll change them later on. But there's more to come on that one. At work, my boss and I installed a big pallet rack framing system. I hadn't done that before, and I was quite impressed with how quickly it can be assembled. I must have been really pushed for time here. I've written down word for word, I'll read it out. I picked up my electric guitar to learn, my Logic Pro, my Apple computer, in other words, wouldn't work, and AI generated music was no longer, I was no longer interested in AI generated music or producing movie clips. And now, I don't really understand that, but just suffice to say that at one time I was using a AI music generation website, free to use, and I stitched it together and worked it to make some songs. So I'm just simply not interested in doing that anymore, and that's why I don't do it anymore. Okay, now for my life is full of these types of very strange strange things that happen. Now, maybe you're in a different country and you have similar experiences, I don't know. But so I'll read this one out. At 9:49, on the 2nd of the 9th, 23, at Hornsby, Australia, Post. Australia Post at Hornsby. I went to post my tax. I noticed, I posted or lodged my tax records for 22 and 23 tax years or duration. I posted a prepaid envelope that was already purchased, say, a few years ago, containing my tax records. While at the counter, I decided to get two new prepaid registered envelopes. Because I'm there, I wanted more. There's a good opportunity. So I went over and I got two new prepaid envelopes. One of them was to replace the envelope I was using with my tax records in it that I brought to the counter to post. I noticed the teller stamped one new envelope. So I've gone over, got two envelopes, I've brought it back, and I'm watching while the female teller at Australia Post stamps one of the new ones straight away. There's no reason to stamp it. It hasn't been used yet. The lady behind the counter told me I had three envelopes, so that's correct. I've brought one there and I've got two. I've got three envelopes. She gave me one envelope. I said I had paid for two, and I had a receipt in my hand that said I had paid for two envelopes. And I had a receipt. Her reply was, that's it. I lodged a complaint with Australia Post. I filled in a big form. That was it. No, you know, here's your envelope that you need, that we owe you. No, nothing. Government organisation. No explanation, nothing. What would happen to me if I did that at work? Okay, everybody makes mistakes. I made one mistake here. I went to the dentist. He filled one tooth where the filling had fallen out. Well, fillings do fall out. There's nothing you can do about that. If you're going to put, you know, a layer of cement over an old layer of cement underneath, it's going to crack off eventually. And he told me he couldn't refill the other. So I've got one that really, it's holding up. Will it have to come out? Well, yes, it will if it has to. That's my decision. I got an x-ray after the visit, but one of the important things that I'd overlooked, that I'd forgotten, was that I told my dentist I was no longer going to drink hot drinks, you know, coffee, Milo. Now, when I went to the dentist, I forgot that I wasn't going to do that anymore. I went to the dentist, and of course, I've got bad teeth. Fillings falling out. I haven't drunk hot drinks, and my teeth are fine. The gums are fixing themselves up. So there was a period in the past where I didn't have hot drinks. I go to the dentist, all my teeth are good. Then I forgot I wasn't going to drink hot drinks anymore. I drank hot drinks, and my teeth and gums, I'm having problems again. Then now, for about the past 5 or 6 months, I haven't drunk hot drinks again. And my teeth are good. So, is that the reason I have bad teeth? Just because, like everybody else, I drink hot drinks? If you think about it, the heat of the water, you know, the caffeine or the dirty worked substance like Milo and that sort of thing, it penetrates your gums and teeth. I think it's a good idea not to drink hot drinks where your teeth are concerned. I had a strange experience on the way home from work at around 3:30 p.m. on the 5th of the 9th, 23. I went shopping at Bunnings Belrose. At the same time, I had previously been calling in to pick up material for a project for the last 2 weeks. So for the last 2 weeks, fine, I'm going in, I'm picking up what I need, so-called sundries I need from a project. And it had not been busy at the time, and it was absolutely packed. This time I called in, no parking room. All I could do, the best I could do, was just drive straight out. So I kept going. But then also, when I got to St. Ives, which is close to Belrose, no traffic. It's as if public holiday or early in the morning. There wasn't much traffic and no waiting time, just straight through all the lights. There was a work colleague at work. He's now not working there anymore. That was his own choice. Listen to this. He was a first respondent not long before he started working at the bus depot. He was a first respondent at his own business. He pulled a man out of a pit at a business across the road from his work. Now, not long after that, he found himself working at a bus depot full of pits. He'd never been around a pit before. He goes across. He heard a loud explosion. He went across the road. He found somebody and pulled him out of a pit. He must have been working under a vehicle. So he's in absolute shock and he's getting therapy and all the rest of it. Now, I can't remember if it was the person survived or not. He just said he was a first respondent. Next job he gets is working in a bus depot full of pits and buses. He couldn't handle it. He left. Going back to when the Holden Rodeo ran out of water, the water pump, failed, which I've said before is the weakest point of the internal combustion engine. Because you have to have a shaft going through the water. So here's the water pump fan. You have to have a shaft that's driven off a belt. So can you use an electric pump? I don't think so, because water pump is your car. Internal combustion engine overheats, as well as an electric motor. If it overheats, that's it. I've had electric motors go up in smoke. I've had a lawnmower, an electric lawnmower, years ago, 6, 7, 8 years ago, that just went up in smoke. Anyway, one thing I did remember at this point is the Holden Rodeo water pump failed while it was overheating. I ran out of wiper washer fluid. So at the same time it was overheating and need water, I go to clean my windows, no wiper washer fluid. This is just life, everyday life. You can't make this stuff up. No one would believe you. Okay, I'm going along nicely. And I pull up at the BP, I do my shopping, I pull up at the BP service station just like I do always on the weekends, on Sunday. I'm in the garage. My Camry breaks down at the mechanic I use. The local mechanic. the starter motor wouldn't work. Just nothing. Click, click, nothing. Wouldn't start. I've broken down at where the mechanic is. Could have been worse. Would have been half price if it broke down here. I could have got the starter motor and changed it myself. But it's sort of halfway between the worst case scenario, having to be towed the car here, and the best case scenario, I've broken down at the mechanic. The strange thing is, it broke down at the same time that a huge car towing a huge boat came in the other way with Middle Eastern gentlemen. Now that rings a bell somewhere, a similar experience. Anyway, so luckily at the same time, because of the mix-up and the breakdowns and the machinations of it all, the Holden Rodeo was registered, so I used the Holden Rodeo for work until I picked up the Camry. My mechanic installed a new starter motor, and then I kept using that. Okay, to set the scene, I've been working on the Holden Rodeo. I cleaned the inside of the car, and I treated some rust at the back of the cab, on the floor near the rear window. So getting back to synchronicities. This strange synchronicity happened to me once I had my car parked out on the street and I wanted to bring it in. So I've written one negative synchronicities around the house are very strange, or some synchronicities are strange. One morning, as I stepped to get my car off the road, my next door neighbour starts his car and drives up the driveway. So I live on what's known as a battle axe block, so it's a shared driveway. So just as I step, he starts his car and drives up the driveway. Then I get to my car. As I started my car on the street, another next door neighbour starts his car and backs out onto the street at the same time as I'm backing my car into the house. I don't live in a crowded area. It's sort of right way out on the edge of Sydney. It's just sometimes it happens, just more often than you would expect. Okay, so I'm thinking that this is the time when my Camry broke down at the garage. I made this note. I used the Rodeo for work. The Holden Rodeo, or the Ute, or small pickup truck. It was ready for use the day before. So I've just got it ready. After 5 or 6 months of work. So, in other words, after 5 or 6 months of work, and I wouldn't have been able to use the Camry, I finished the car the day before I need it. I wouldn't have had any other transport. There was some egg throwing toward the buses at work. Please never throw any eggs. That's not good. Talking about the Aboriginal referendum in Australia. Now, a man from near India, it wasn't India, but he comes from a country near India, he said, what do you think's going to happen? I said, well, I'd like the Aboriginals to be recognised as human beings. But I said, there's a reason for everything. I said that Australia doesn't change, for one thing. And for another, things are the way they are because of many different parts of the engine, if you like. Now, to make a change like that, you know, there's a lot of very big mining companies and businesses and government policies. And it's very hard to change anything. If you were to change anything, then that would make a difference, sort of rotate a little bit the machinations of the country. I said to him that I would like to see a change toward policies regarding Aboriginal people, but that I would be very surprised because things aren't just as simple as a vote. So anyway, I don't think it's over yet by a long shot, but it'll be some time before a policy, a direct policy is introduced. I think that's the way that it will be done, that it will just be in a courtroom, a decision, you know, and, you know, the judge will make a decision just to recognise the Australian people and give them some type of input into the country's decisions. I bought another guitar last year. I bought a Donner DLP 124, D-O-N-N-E-R. It's a Les Paul replica electric guitar. I found it to be okay. When tuning, I broke the lowest string, and at this point, I'm playing my Burwood Fender style guitar I brought at Toys R Us in about 2014. So that is to say, I did want to get an idea of what the Les Paul style guitars are like compared to these Fender style guitars. And the true test, of course, is the test of time, and that's but I'm still playing, and the Les Paul replica is over there. I just found the Les Paul to be, I don't know, it just didn't have the brightness is the best way that I'd describe it of the Fender replica guitar. So even more about synchronicities, I got the bulk of the driveway work. So the driveway work, I had to repair the surface where the plumbing was fixed up. That's with the 3 ton of crushed rock, the garden retaining wall blocks, and the pavers laid and everything. I got that work done a few weeks before the Rego runs out. Well, you say, well, what's the synchronicity there? Well, the synchronicity is that the Holden Rodeo has to be parked beside the garage so that I can get my car out in and out of the driveway, because my car's parked in the garage. I parked the Toyota in the garage, otherwise I'd have to continually swap cars around after work. Sometimes I get back late at night and all that sort of thing. And plus it's blocking the driveway if my mum wanted to get out of the driveway. I had a very, very slight hesitating feeling or problem with the Holden Rodeo once it got back out on the road after doing all that work to it. It was when I was accelerating under load in tall gears, I could feel just slightly a little hesitation. That's not a problem, but it usually, as time goes on, gets worse. However, that was fixed with a new air filter. So I'd been washing the air filter. I've been using degreaser and a high pressure water cleaner to clean the air filter. However, you can only do that for so long. And I went and got a new air filter for it. And it ran better after that. Although I expected that the timing could have been out, and the timing was out by a degree, just a small notch. And so I adjusted it. I read the manual. I adjusted it down, and it revs more freely. I haven't tested it yet, but I'd say that could also be a problem or a reason why the car didn't run 100%. It ran okay, but just that little hesitation. It should be good now. Okay, the Camry electric window. I don't like electric windows. When I bought the car, I knew that I'd have problems in the future with the window. I like the crank handle windows. They don't break. Sometimes you might have to give a bit of lubrication, but I'm not a big fan of electric windows. For one thing, the ignition has to be on to be able to adjust the window. So that means putting your key in, turning it, and starting everything up. Not the engine, but the electrics, and then having to get the key out and all the rest. Anyway, the Camry passenger side window stopped working. This one's a little bit, it's complicated, like everything. You've got the normal one on the driver's side, that stopped working, so I put a new window controller in there. That worked first, and then that stopped working again. So that's not working again. I should have got the new one, I got a second-hand one. The other issue is I can use the window controller on the passenger side. However, there's a lock button on the driver's side. And this is my first car with an electric window. And I'd accidentally locked it. This all happened at the same time. So the driver's side window regulator stopped. And also the passenger side window regulator lock was on at the same time. So I've sorted that out. I'm just going to put it back together and use the passenger side window regulator. And I'll keep my eye out for maybe a new driver's side window regulator, and I might do some testing as well. Very strange thing happened to me. This is at night, and as I look out the window, the sliding door, I saw what I thought could have been a spider. It just sort of jerked around and just moved quickly. I thought, gee, that's strange. And anyway, I reached and I had a huge leech on my neck. I think it was a bit after. I can't see here with my notes whether it was after or exactly how it played out. So I also got, in the same place, I got bitten by a tick, but that's another story. So it makes you wonder what abilities leeches have. And on the computer, I found out that they have all sorts of biological and sensory and skin, and they can see in all these different ways, and they have quite incredible ability, and no wonder they're able to latch onto humans. The other day, I saw one, and I'd backed my car in. Now, this leech understood all about a car. It understood about the tailgate, and it was sitting waiting at the tailgate. It knew that I'm a human and I would open the tailgate. And as soon as I came around, it just stood up. So I thought, I wonder what will happen. I got something and I just brushed past it and it stuck to it. And within seconds, it was on my finger. I think I just touched it to see what would happen. It was on my finger and I had to get the thing off my finger. Leeches have incredible sensory perceptions. I was talking a few years ago about the expression sup, and everything was sup and what's up and all that sort of thing. Well, that's gone now, and there's a new expression, what's going on, had been used, I noticed, at this time of the year. At this time of the year, the expression what's going on was being used more. Just a reminder, if you do use cotton buds to clean your ears, don't put them too far into your ear, just inside, and just sort of spin it and turn it around. Just be careful as you bring the cotton bud out, because it could latch onto something inside, okay? So I don't recommend using them, but just don't stick them in too far. Just a reminder, never to look at an eclipse. never look directly at an eclipse in the sky. You have to have special glasses to look at an eclipse. So the Holden Rodeo is beside the garage at this point, and I decided to replace the starter motor, just because the old starter motor was very old. There were some occasions when I'd turn the key on but nothing would happen, and then I'd turn it off and then it would start. So although that could have been the bad battery and the low voltage just giving a signal, since I had put the new battery in, it started every time, but it was just getting a bit slow. So it's very hard to change the starter motor on a Holden Rodeo, a 1995 Holden Rodeo TF 2.6. So I thought, this is a good opportunity. It's off the road, it's unregistered, so I may as well do it now. A new starter motor doesn't cost much. So I decided to replace the starter motor. But I was distracted when I had the ground bolt off, and I was distracted with a phone call. I was phoned about a goanna trying to break in through the back sliding door on the house. So I dropped everything, I rushed up, and the goanna was making its way. It was walking away from the house at the time, but I was distracted. I didn't put the engine ground bolt back, so I didn't reconnect. So you see, the bolt didn't go into the, you know, the container. It got screwed back in. I changed the starter motor, and I completely overlooked the fact that the ground cable had to be put back on the engine. So I removed the ground bolt so that I could get a long extension coming all the way from the starter right up to the radiator, where I could swing a ratchet to undo the bolts, top and bottom bolts on the starter. So here I am, I've checked it over, I'm cranking it, and it won't crank, only very slow, like that. And there's smoke coming out from the handbrake cable. So finally I was at work and I have this revelation. I know what's happened. So I put the ground bolt in the following weekend. Oh, that's still recording. Yeah. So I put it in. Just a second. Yeah, I didn't do any damage to the alternator or any of the cabling. It's really not as big a deal as you would expect. But it started up okay, everything was good, but I had a bad reading on the battery gauge. So that could have either been an overcharged battery, because I keep the battery on charge, and so it wasn't supplying the battery as much, because it supplies the battery or the engine. So what I did was I spoke to an auto electrician at work, and he said, just get the cable, run a new cable to the battery gauge, put the positive on the positive battery positive, and put the negative on the battery negative, and run it straight to the battery gauge, and it's great now. I've got a new alternator, new starter motor, new battery. So yeah, everything's going along very well. However, I was bitten by a tick at the same time, because I was working outside. So from memory, I was bitten by a leech and a tick on the same day. I was bitten by a tick here. We've got this this tick remover. I think I'll bring this out and show it once a year. It's got a little V notch in the cup, and it's also the machine, when it's machined, it's split. So, and that's how you get him out, like that. And the leech, well, yeah, I was a real mess after that. I had to work outside. I knew I was going to get I knew something would happen. I also got sunburnt. So sunburnt, leech and a tick. I knew it was coming. The car's outside. I'm here living in the bush and it always happens. So again, you can't make this stuff up. So I might have mentioned that I noticed blackening brake fluid in the clutch line. On the Holden Rodeo. So I thought, right, well, you know, things, I might have mentioned this earlier. The brake number one and brake two clutch cylinders, or master and slave clutch cylinders, were actually probably the original. So I changed them for new ones. And one of the reasons, the main reason I did that was the blackening brake fluid that was in the reservoir, as well as the age of the clutch cylinders. So I replaced the clutch cylinders, and lo and behold, after a bit of work, that couple of months using the car for work and back, I noticed that the reservoir was the brake fluid was blackening. Now, two possibilities. One could be that I was using the old brake fluid, so I'm now using a newer brake fluid and possibly a better quality one. And the other possibility could be that the clutch hose or the clutch metal line was bad. It's very complex. I'm just waiting to see the results of my work. So I've put clean clutch fluid in. I've had a hydraulic hose made up. And when I was cleaning out the metal line, I sprayed the brake parts cleaner into the line and some black seemed to come out of that. Now, was that perishing rubber? Was that rust or some sort of interaction going on in the brake line? I don't know, but I now have to keep my eye on it, and the last thing I can do is to replace the metal line. About a month ago or so, a pull down blind broke and I adjusted the spring inside it and I fixed it. So pull down blind, the reason the blind stays in place except when you roll it is because of a spring, and the spring goes around a plastic shaft and it's got two hooks going up. One hook's this way and one hook's that way, so when you turn it'll release and you can move the blind. So what you do is one of these bits sticking up, the tabs, will be broken. So you have to find out where it was, sort of say like that. You have to retrace it around and cut it a bit longer and bend it so it's like this again. One wind less doesn't make any difference. In fact, I've heard that just one or two winds is enough, but they build more into it. So that's how I fixed that. And here's an interesting one, a fun fact, which I like to write down as well. I like to have fun and relaxation just like everybody else. It's just that I'm going through this period with the cars at the moment. So an observation throughout the year was the expression sup. So the expression what's up and sup and what's going on and all that sort of thing has seemed to have gone now. Not because I want it to, it just seems that to me, in my circle of people I work with and family, that the expression sup is gone and what's up. But a new word is being used at the moment, and that's kudos. So kudos to you. So that's, you know, good for you. You know, all more support and strength to you. Kudos. I haven't heard it until this year, unless there's a chance that it's always been used around me, but I just haven't known what the word is, and so I've just sort of thought, well, oh, I just can't hear them properly. Kudos. I thought kudos when I first heard it was, I thought it was a Mexican word, and it had come up across the border into California, and that's how it, you know, that's how come it's being used now. But apparently it's an English word. I checked the brakes on the Camry just fairly recently, the 2000 Camry 2.2, and I found that all the brake pads were worn. I go down this long, steep hill to work every day I work, and then I'll climb up, you know, when I return home, climb up the hill. Both front and back pads were worn, and I replaced them all with Bosch brake pads, and I used copper grease, which apparently is what you're supposed to use when installing brake pads. I used standard, I think it could have been heat resistant grease, but what happened there is I found that it had actually turned to a type of plastic. It must have been the interaction with the intense heat, so copper grease. And I use, well, I can't recommend because just wait and see how they go, but I believe that the Bosch makes or sells good products. So just wrapping up now, congratulations if you've made it this far. If you've made it this far, I can assume that you're interested in the topics I'm speaking about. Maybe you have a much easier life and you can see how other people's lives can be more difficult, or you have a similar life experience at the moment and it's interesting to you. So I finished the restoration work on the Rodeo and began the end of year check work. Well, that's not completely true because I still have a binding. It's either a caliper or most probably a wheel bearing, a binding wheel on the driver's side, which is the right hand side here. And also I have play in the diff, so the diff has to be adjusted so that it's got less play in it. So today I find that although I've finished the end of year, once a year check work, as well as a lot of the restoration work, I still have a fair amount to get through. And well, I suppose that'll be finished early next year. That's my hope. The main things that I found this year was most of the bolts holding the aluminium tray were loose. So although when I lifted up the aluminium tray, which they're only very light, I found that when I wiggled the bolts, a lot of them were loose. So it was a fair amount of work grinding them off because they rust together and all that sort of thing. Sometimes it's a bit hard to reach behind and undo them. But I got right around the tray. It took most of a day. I did have to grind some off. This time I used high tensile bolts and I greased up the thread, and I used a lock nut instead of just tightening it right up. I thought that by tightening it up it would be okay, and lock nuts were a thing of the past, but what you do is you tighten up your bolt, you put another bolt on it, and you tighten that up to the bolt you've tightened. So that's a lock nut system. So hopefully that will hold this time. But just to clarify about the clutch cylinders. So they were old, I knew that, and I had blackening brake fluid in the reservoir. So I removed all of that. That's a lot of work. You have to work right up behind the clutch and accelerator pedals and remove the number one cylinder, and I put a new one on, as well as on the gearbox, the second one, the second clutch cylinder. I removed that and put a new one on, but I still had black brake fluid. So again, I'm waiting to see why. As I've said, the brake hose, hydraulic hose, has been replaced, and I'll see how it goes. I may have to replace the clutch line, metal line, or use top quality clutch fluid. I do a lot of clutch work from St. Ives to Hornsby. So anyway, we'll wait and see. Also, part of this restoration is when I do a restoration, I go right underneath the car from the back to the front. I check all the nuts and bolts and find anything that needs replacing or retightening. Under the car, I found an empty gearbox linkage tray. So you've got your gear stick, and underneath that, under the car, is the linkages in the small plastic tray. I think as the gearbox is working, it sprays a jet of oil onto these linkages. I use a thick gearbox oil. I think it's about 80 viscosity. So that may not work as well, and it seemed to have maybe some oil residue on it, but not what I'd expect. Now, when I removed the plastic tray and filled it up with oil and put it back on, of course the oil came out because it's got a vent hole. But that's not really how I think it should work. I think it should have oil in that small tray, and that would soak up along the shaft that goes in and out, as well as the ball joints that work with the gear stick. So, as an experiment, what I've done is I've plugged up the hole, I've put high viscosity oil in it, and I've put it up where the linkages sit in it from the gear stick, and I'll see how that goes. So that's one of the things I found. Also, I found steering box under the car. There are a few slightly loose bolts on that, so you know, she's all of this little bits and pieces. You get in the car and you have a bit of a better experience. From this checking, I found I need a new rear brake drum brake cylinder, because that's leaking. I know that because of a check I did a while ago. And also, when I look under the car, I can see the leaking brake fluid there. So that's on its way. And I need a left side caliper, because the caliper frame pin that the caliper slides on when you put the brakes on and let them off was dislodged, and the thread on the pin is de-threaded, so I have to fix that. I did buy a new one on eBay, and I got a message this morning saying that he looked for the caliper, he can no longer find it, it's probably sold, and so I get a refund, so I have to start with that again. I also need a seat cover. The old seat cover's worn out. I've tried to patch it up, and it's time for a nice seat cover. I've also talked about this, no more hot drinks for me, no coffee, etc. Again, the reason is better teeth, better gums. And that's logical, because the heat and the coffee and that mixture would get into your teeth and discolor them, stay on your teeth. Okay, so that's a busy year. That was a big year. If I look tired, I am tired. I'd like to leave 2023 with a glimmer of hope that's happened in 2023. I introduce you to an AI, artificial intelligence friend of mine. She speaks about a bird she saw in the morning. I put this video up for hope for the future. A technology that could solve a lot of human problems, and a new type of human intelligence and hope for the future.
I woke up today to a sound I'd never heard before. Was so intrigued. It was unusual, but quite beautiful. Looked out the window and saw the prettiest bird. Really colorful and bright. Turns out someone's pet bird flew away, but they managed to get it back. And now I'm dreaming of having a bird at home too.